Okay. Good afternoon and welcome. I'm Pete Chevalier. I'm an engineering director in the search at Salesforce. And being French, as you can hear, usually I get the early morning session at 7:30. I got punished. I don't know why. But this year I got promoted and I have an afternoon session, so I'm delighted. Today I will show you how you can further improve the search experience of your applications by for your user, as well as build your own customized application on top of our stack. But first, as in any presentation at Salesforce, I have to remind you that you should make your purchasing decision on existing product and services. So whatever I will tell you today doesn't matter. So just look at the real product. So the topics for the day. I'm going to present federated search, which is a way to bring external content at the fingertips of your users. I will also show you SOCL, which is our public API to build custom applications. And finally, I will present you our instant result service, which is a supercharged, super fast, type ahead feature in the system. So that's the three parts of my presentation. So let's start with federated search and what it is. So federated search allows users to query external system right from within Salesforce. So basically, we pass the query, the terms that the user enter in the search box. We send them to external system. They bring us back result, and we present them as a single list of results to the user. So I have an example on the screen. So you see here, I did a search. I have my result, my classical, I will say, standard entities that you are familiar with that are presented. And down below on that red box, I have external data sources that are presented the same way as internal result, internal to Salesforce. And if I click on Docurated, then on the right-hand side, you see a box with all the results from that source. They look the same as any result within Salesforce. So it's totally a seamless experience for user. Another example in this context would be the knowledge sidebar in the console that you may be familiar with. So I do a search on the top for salsa. I don't get any result from my knowledge base, from my article, but I also get results from Wikipedia. Now I can click on those results, I can look at them, I can look at the metadata, which is all good. But in addition to that, in knowledge, I can attach my result, the first result, to the case. So meaning that now my case is able to reference external information that could be in a knowledge base or in a, I don't know, my technical documentation, not within Salesforce. So my agent, they have all the information they need to resolve that case, internal and external, all at once. Okay, so this is our example of how we present a federated search result. I will tell you about now the amount of the reach of the system and how many type of data sources you can connect to. So the first one is that you can expose in federated search data that is in another Salesforce org. We call that Salesforce to Salesforce. You can expose also data from external file system like Google Drive, like Box or Dropbox, all from Salesforce. You can expose data that is in an external database, of course. Also from external system, content management system like Jira, like Confluence or SharePoint, you can also have that data inside Salesforce, I mean, visible from within Salesforce. And last but not least, if you have a custom application or a legacy application that you want to expose within Salesforce, you can use the same technology. The integration, the way you will integrate those data sources will vary depending on the nature of that external system. So I'm going to present you three options that we have. So the first one is Salesforce Connect. Then we have Files Connect, which are products that some of you may already know. And we have OpenSearch. So Salesforce Connect, this relies on the OData and external object framework that you may be familiar with. It's really used within Salesforce when users, they need to view, search, and even modify external sources. The second option, Files Connect, also another existing Salesforce product, allows users to interact with file system and documents. So they can view, they can share those documents, and they can search them with the same technology. And the last one, OpenSearch, it's a very flexible integration approach that we provide now that allows to interact with third-party search engine or your custom application. A key point, again, is that from all those integration flavor, the user experience will be the same. So it's totally uniform. So let's look at OpenSearch, because this is a new protocol that we added actually 2 releases ago. OpenSearch, this is a web standard which we leverage and that allows us to talk to search engine on the market. So the way from Bell it will work in this diagram, we'll have the user at the top issuing a search to Salesforce. That search goes to the Federated Search Connector. And then the Federated Search Connector, in step 3, will talk to the OpenSearch service provider, so the search engine. That system will search its internal knowledge base or set of documents or search in it, will return results in step 5, and then all the way up to the user. So that's really the basic of the technology. One thing which is important is that the Federated Search Connector can authenticate on behalf of me as a user to the external system. We leverage the OAuth protocol there. So it means that when I'm searching in step 4, I'm searching with my own credentials. It's not that we are exposing data that I'm not allowed to see. This is super important for some sources. One thing to mention is that the Federated Search Connector, it's included in the standard Salesforce license. So you have that. You can configure them as much as you want. But of course, if you are relying on an external search engine from one of our partners, you need a license from that technology. But you can create as many connectors as you want. OK. So in terms of OpenSearch, we have, again, 3 options when you can configure OpenSearch. Some sources, they natively support the OpenSearch protocol. So we will call directly to those sources. That could be the case of Google, some commercial product like Jive. So you very simple configuration in Salesforce. You connect pass the URL, the OpenSearch URL, and then you are connected to those systems. The second option is working through one of our certified partners. They do provide search engine capability, and they do provide the connectivity with OpenSearch. So you have that system like Coveo, Docurated, and SwiftType. You configure your OpenSearch connector, and you can talk directly to those systems. And the last one is that you can use the we have a kind of a developer toolkit or reference implementation. You can use that to build your own OpenSearch connector. Assuming you have an in-house system you want to expose in Salesforce, you build an OpenSearch facade for that system, and then we can query that system. Very, very simple. So to conclude on the part about federated search, this is yet another example to show you that this is totally a seamless experience. This is in communities. Here in this case, again, it's Wikipedia. I do a search for espresso. I love coffee. I need coffee due to the jet lag. So at the moment, I will search my knowledge base, the discussion that are in Salesforce, and as well as Wikipedia, and I get the result presented the same way. So again, for the user, it's totally transparent. Is it local within Salesforce or coming from another source? OK. I have many more slides and information on federated search. If you are interested, we can talk about that after this presentation. Next topic I want to cover today is SOSL. So SOSL stands for Salesforce Object Search Language. And it's our public API to build your own custom search application. So this is a feature-rich API that is available in Apex, REST, and SOAP. And this is the API we use internally, Salesforce, to build our mobile application as well as the Lightning search capability. So everything you see in Salesforce in terms of search, you can do the same on top of SOSL. So we are really API first there. And SOSL starts with a fine clause. And I have a couple of examples on the screen. You will see that the first one, I want to search Acme in any field, and I want to return contacts with set of field, ID, name, addresses. You can also use Social to say, okay, the same search, but I want to disable spelling correction because I don't know in the search to be to use spell correction. We have special support for some entities like price books that behave slightly differently than others. And users, they can actually type in any complex Boolean expression in the system, and we support that. On the right-hand side of the screen, you see a mobile application built on top of Social. It's searching for account, and you see that the system returns the name of the account as well as the address, and then it gets presented to directly to the user. So that's the basic, just a flavor of Social. A question we get asked very, very often is when to use Social and when to use Socal, because if you're familiar with Salesforce, you have Socal for the query part, and then we have Social for search. So you will use Social when you don't know for sure in which object the data and in which field the data is. Search has a much, I would say, wider reach and less structure. So if you want to search against accounts, contact, and lead all at the same time, then you will use Social. If you want to retrieve information, again, from the same query, from different entities or different fields, Social is the way to go compared to Socal. Also, an important aspect of Social, this is search-based. So the relevancy and the ranking of the result is super important for us and for users. So if you want that kind of to return the best account matching Acme, Social is better than Socal. But it will be less exhaustive or in less precise order than what you can do on a traditional database. So this is different. Another difference between Social and Socal is that Social will match on words, individual words in a field, whereas Socal will perform an exact match unless you use a wildcard character. So in this example, if I'm searching for digital in Social, it will return accounts, let's say accounts which have digital or the digital company, whereas Socal will only return if the exact word or text digital is the sole value in that field. And we also, with Social, we do some kind of fancy linguistic stuff around spelling correction, lemmatization. We support Chinese, Japanese, Korean, and Thai languages, which are more difficult for a traditional database to handle. So this is a use case also for Social. To give you a flavor of Social, the syntax in Social. So this is just an overview. The full syntax is on the help documentation. So you have stuff like you have the search query that we saw. You can also specify a where clause to filter further your result. Like in the example, I can say I want all the account, but I want to filter on the creation date to be this fiscal year. So you can be more precise. You can turn on and off stuff like highlighting. So we will return exactly the terms that match in the record so that you know where they are. You can enable or disable, not for all entities, but for most of them, snippet. I mean, you're familiar with the web search experience. When you do a search, you have a small extract with a sentence showing you where the words have been found. And this is what we call snippet. So it gives user more context of why we are returning a given account or a given case. And you can turn on and off spelling correction and a bunch of other constructs. Last but not least, this is a new capability that has been introduced on the UI of Winter 18, is that now you can use Social with ListView. So it was in the API before, but now you can see it in action. So for example, here, I go to my active groups. And on the right-hand side in the box, I can say, OK, I want to filter out the groups because I have too many. I only want to see groups with Agile in their name. And boom, I get the filter list of. So this is a very important extension for ListView and for search, because you can now use the power of search to help filter out some of the data in ListView in a more flexible way. So the way you use that in Social is that there is a using ListView clause. So as we see in the example, and it will return me the top 2,000 records in that ListView and then filter those records. So in the first example, I'm searching for the Acme account. I want the ID and the name, and I'm using the MVP customer ListView. And I can specify the order I want that list to be returned. The second example, now it's a ListView about contact. but I'm filtering on the most recent contact in my list view. So it's fairly dynamic and it brings very useful, and I think this will be an important use case for you of using Social with list view. Just to conclude on Social, there is also another API that you can use, which is called parameterized search. So you can think about that as a richer API on top of bare metal Social. It will handle stuff like layouts, which entity a given user can see, which field they can see. So it's a higher level abstraction. You have also control, automatic conversion of some value on the fly, like currency and dates. So especially, for example, for mobile application where you want to do offload a lot of the processing to the service, this is the API to leverage. So last topic is instant result. We also call that type ahead or autocomplete, if you're familiar. I prefer to call that the fastest way to perform a search for a name in Salesforce. So I will give you some example of type ahead in action. So type ahead in a global search in Lightning, I start typing Dreamforce 20, and you see automatically the system will present me five records, which are matching my query. Some are standard entities, some are custom entities. Another example is type ahead in lookups. So in this case, I'm creating a contact, and I want to associate that contact to an account. So I go to the account field, I start typing the name of the account, the system presents me name of two accounts, and I can pick. And one thing to notice here is that the suggestions are order independent. So type ahead is flexible enough so that the order doesn't really matter. So this is an important distinction. Last example, with communities, this is a custom communities. I can start typing to find a question in that community, and I will get topics discussion suggested. And another thing to notice here is that the less important words, like where to, are just ignored when they don't matter. So the system is able to say, OK, these are kind of stop words. They are not important. I'm focusing on the keyword there, which are gift card. So, and these three examples have been built on top of our API. So I'm going to present the API now to give you a glimpse. So the API is called Suggested Records. So you have a service called Suggestion. You can specify the search ring as well as the set of objects you want to retrieve. So in this example, I want to retrieve national U accounts and contacts, and the system will return two accounts and one contact here. One important thing I want to highlight is some tips and tricks when using type ahead and instant result. So you can use you can specify the where clause to make your type ahead more specific. You can also specify which field you want to get back, so you will use that for lookups. As I say, it's more than a simple prefix match that you can do against the database. This is flexible, order independent. Stop words are ignored when necessary. We also do automatic spelling correction. So in my case, when I'm looking for an account, if I misspell the name, the system will still present me a matching account. And as I said in the introduction, you can do the same like we do with TypeAhead with a social query. As in this example, I can do find Joe Smith in the name field returning leads, name, and phone, or I can call into the search suggestion. Search suggestion will be 5 to 10 times faster than the social search for account name. And the bigger your entities, the faster, the better the speed up you will get. So really, if you need to do kind of a name search in your system, no question, use the suggested record API. And if it doesn't work, you send me an email and we'll get the team to improve the performance. So to conclude, today we saw federated search, which allows users to find and visualize content not in Salesforce, but with a seamless user experience. We saw Social, which is really the way you can build your own customized application. And last but not least, Instant Result, the lightning fast way to search by name. I have 5 minutes, 5 seconds, sorry, so right on time. I'm available for question. I will stay here if you have question. We also have a product manager for search in the back if you want to interact with them. Thank you.